Welcome. Please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance, presented by Kayla Ripka, and remain standing for the National Anthem and Alma Mater, led by Springstead Chorus and Mr. Mark Pennington.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please be seated.
Good evening. I'm Lieutenant Colonel Darryl Sweetwine, one of the junior ROTC instructors here at Springstead High School. Myself, along with Chief Master Sergeant Ty Williams, administer the Air Force Junior ROTC program here at Springstead High. At this time, I'd like to recognize the graduates who are entering our nation's military upon graduation. Graduates, please stand when your name is called and remain standing until all names have been called. Kyron Alvarez, United States Navy. Christian Bagan, United States Army. Michael Barrientos, United States Air Force. Caitlin Changping, United States Army. Tyler Drews, United States Marine Corps. Charles A. Irwin, United States Air Force Academy. Connor Thomas Ferris, United States Marine Corps. Luke Ferrara, United States Army. Heather Fryer, United States Air Force. Luides Garcia, United States Navy. Mika Gilpin, United States Air Force. Sincere Gomez, United States Navy. Jeremiah Holmes, United States Army. Logan Lauter, United States Air Force. Destiny Lely, United States Army. Vincent Lynch, United States Navy. Matthew Maldonado, United States Marine Corps. Nicholas Mester, United States Air Force. Vanessa Noah, United States Air Force. John Parker, United States Military Academy at West Point. Navaya Renoa, United States Air Force. Neralis Rivera, Army National Guard. Samari Rivera, United States Air Force. Zacharias Searles, United States Air Force. Derek Villa, United States Army. And Michael Welshans, United States Navy. Thank you all for deciding to serve our great nation. Godspeed to each and every one of you. You may be seated.
Good evening, I'm Grace Flogger, and I would like to welcome the graduates, their families, friends, and our educators to the graduation ceremony for the Springstead class of 2019. The day we've all been anticipating has finally arrived. The countless hours spent studying, practicing for sports, or rehearsing for performances have brought us to this exact moment. I'd like to take this time to thank our loved ones for encouraging us to succeed and comforting us when we didn't. Their constant support and even their nagging have pushed us to become the best versions of ourselves. Our success is a reflection of their love and assistance throughout our lives. Motivational speaker Jim Rohn once said, "Happiness is not something you postpone for the future. It is something you design for the future." Don't forget to live in this moment. The future after graduation may seem ambiguous and at times scary, but happiness does not need to be lost in the process of achieving success. Now it is time for us to leave this eagle's nest that we've called our home and fly wherever our dreams may take us. I wish you all the best of luck on your journey.
Good evening, everyone, and thank you for joining us tonight. My name is Kyra Riggins. For all of us graduating this evening, high school was the first step in setting our pace towards adulthood. This accomplishment is a great one, but before we can celebrate ourselves, we must remember those essential to our success. To our distinguished guests, please stand when called. And to our audience, please hold your applause until the end. It is my honor to introduce Mr. John Stratton, our Superintendent of Schools, Ms. Heather Martin, our Deputy Superintendent, Ms. Susan Duvall, our School Board Chairperson, Ms. Linda K. Prescott, our School Board Vice Chairperson, Mr. Gus Guadagnino, Ms. Kay Hatch, and Mr. Jimmy Lodato, our School Board Members, Ms. Gina Michalica, our Executive Director of Academic Services, Mr. Carmine Rufa, our Principal, Mr. Rick Markford, Mr. Don McNaughton, Ms. Dana Pierce, and Mr. John Weaver, our Assistant Principals, Ms. Vanessa Sefakul, and Mr. Brandon Wright, our Senior Class Sponsors. Although I cannot list them all, I would also like to recognize our teachers and staff and ask them to stand as well. Thank you for all your dedication to our enrichment, safety, readiness, and development. On behalf of the class of 2019, thank you for making all of this possible. Everyone, please be seated.
Hey everyone, thanks so much for joining us tonight as we ceremoniously conclude one chapter in our lives and heartily spring into the next. In just a moment, our salutatorian will step up to the podium of honor to usher in this new era for the class of 2019. But before he does, just a few words on our Mr. Dustin Falconberry. So Dustin is a good friend of mine, and in fact, I've known him in varying capacities since second grade. And we've been through a lot since then, like you do. But one thing that has remained constant in all that time has been his humility. For those who don't know, Dustin is markedly intellectual and excels within and without school walls. And he's an IB and AP scholar featured in several of our school's musical productions, is a skilled keyboardist, he's awesome, you should listen, a history fair veteran, and an insurmountable asset to the academic team. And he also happens to be a paragon of the human form. thank you. All of this and more never goes to his head, though, for he'll definitely be among the stars on the stage tonight. He never lets it go to his head, I said that, because Dustin himself always puts others first, always considers others first. He's very selfless, and that is reason most of all for why you are about to hear from someone with the heart to actually have something to say. So please join me in welcoming to the podium our Dustin Falconberry.
Friends, family, and esteemed guests, it is my honor to be able to stand before you as the salutatorian of the class of 2019. It isn't an easy task to do the past 4 years justice in 3 minutes, but I'll give it my best shot. I could spend this time talking about the brightness of your futures, taking the road less traveled, or blazing your own trail, but that really wouldn't be anything you haven't heard before. I could tell some short stories about the good times we had, filling them with as much nostalgia as I could manage, and maybe throwing in some one-liners to lighten the mood. But I've only got a little time with you today, and I think that'd be a bit of a waste. So instead, let's talk about a mountain. I'm referring to the mountain on which we all stand here today. It is a mountain 4 years tall, its jagged faces covered in the countless obstacles we faced each day, from that test that seemed a little too hard, to that day that seemed a little too long, to that morning alarm that seemed to ring just a little too early. From where we stood at the bottom, there were many days when the climb seemed just a little too hard to make. But here we stand at the summit, taking a moment to reflect on the view before us, that view which is the sum of all we've achieved in our time together as a class. We made it. However, let us not forget that we did not make this climb alone. Through each leg of our journey, there were times where we lost our footing and we felt ourselves start to fall. And each time, there was a hand reaching down to us to pull us back up, to tell us that our climb wouldn't end here, and to show us the way to the top. That hand represents the many incredible people that have stood by us as we made our perilous climb. That hand is the mother, waking up at the crack of dawn to drive a freshman to school. It is the father, staying up late to help his son with math homework, even if he doesn't quite understand it all. It is the English teacher pouring her third cup of coffee as she picks up the 100th essay she's graded that day. It is the administrators, custodians, lunch ladies, coaches, school resource officers, and school board members waking up day after day after day because they believed in one thing, and that is us. We wouldn't be here were it not for them, and for their dedication to our education, we bear an unpayable debt of gratitude. 3 years ago, a man named Jay Strack stood on a stage at a leadership conference and asked me one question. What would you do if you knew you could not fail? It was a powerful challenge, one that I didn't quite have an answer for. In fact, I'm not too proud to admit that since that day, I've lived my life with the constant fear that I would indeed fail. I've let it paralyze me and force me into the status quo. Each day, I was content to climb just another 10 feet up the mountain because I was scared I might slip. Well, now I'm at the top, and I've got a choice to make. I can climb back down and give up everything I've worked for, or I could just stay at the top, content with the ease of mediocrity. But there's a third option. I could run, give up the safety of everything I've known before, and take a leap from the ledge just to see if I'll fly. And fellow students, I want to see you take that leap with me. We might fall, we might crash, and we might lose it all. But in the end, it's well worth the risk because we just might soar, and for that reason, we have to try. We have to leave the safety of the mountain for the freedom of the skies, where we'll take big risks and follow crazy dreams, all because we finally have an answer to that question. What could we do if we knew we could not fail? And that answer is anything. I stand before you today fully convinced that every single one of you can change the world, because I've seen the potential in every one of you I've met along the way. So don't be afraid to do the impossible. Don't spend your life on the edge of that cliff, wishing you had had the courage to take just one more step. Close your eyes, take the leap, and fly like the eagles you are. Good night, everybody, and God bless you.
Hello everyone, my name is Ryan Bradley, and for the past 4 years, I have been honored to serve as one of your class officers. I would like to introduce our class quote. I encourage you to live with life, be courageous, adventurous, give us a tomorrow more than we deserve. This quote from Maya Angelou shows us that everyone has been or will have to be great courageous at one point in their life. I could stand up here all night telling our family and friends of the many ways we are courageous on a daily basis. But for the sake of time, I will simply share a few. For our athletes, it took courage to try out for a team. For those of us in band, chorus, or theater, it took courage to perform in front of others. For those of us in clubs or leadership positions, it took courage to share our thoughts and ideas. For all of us, it took courage to come to school, and it took courage to face life's abundant challenges. But most importantly, it takes courage to walk across this stage tonight. It is important that you are not fearful of what is to come, but rather face it with bravery. Be willing to venture outside your comfort zone and follow your passions, as this is what success is built upon.
Hello, everyone. My name is Grace Andress, and I am one of your student class officers. I am very proud of everyone here, and am excited about what the future holds for all of us. Tonight, I'm going to be talking to you about our class song, I'll Be There For You, made popular by the TV show Friends. This song deals with being there for your friends through the good times and the bad. When in high school, being there for you meant hoping someone who was stuck on a homework assignment giving someone advice when choosing a prom dress, or sitting by someone at lunch who looks like they may be having a bad day. However, the meaning of the song, now that we are leaving Springstead, is going to change. The song says, "I'll be there for you, like I've been there before." No longer, though, are we going to be there for each other on a daily basis. In our life, things may not always go as planned, and we may at times be stuck in second gear. But when it hasn't been your day, your week, your month, or even your year, remember that the people that sit by you today will always be there for you, no matter where your path takes you.
Hi, my name is Melissa Reyes, and I have had the privilege of serving as class officer representative for all 4 years. I'm here tonight to talk about the class color, blue, that was chosen to represent the class of 2019. Blue represents intelligence, an intelligence that we have used in various ways to allow us to be here as part of the 2019 graduating class. Various students this year will be earning a high school diploma as well as their AA degree. Other students will have certifications that will allow them to have employment right after high school. That is, we've all been through hours of homework, sleepless nights, and difficult assignments. However, our cleverness has allowed us to overcome those obstacles and achieve our goal of walking across this stage, acquiring our high school diploma. Blue is also symbolic of loyalty. We have shown our loyalty to Springstead during homecoming week. Those of us who didn't have classes on campus or reduced schedules still managed to come to school to represent our class during Eagle Games. Many of us spent hours after school rehearsing for the claw or painting billboards in hopes of being the best and winning. Some of us showed our loyalty through sports and earning titles for the school. The class of 2019 is one of a kind, and I am graduating this evening grateful that I have had the opportunity to grow with my classmates these past 4 years.
Hello, my name is Leslie Vaughn, and I have been a class officer for all 4 years at Springstead. Earlier this year, our class chose the forget-me-not as our class flower. The forget-me-not symbolizes a connection that lasts through time, it invokes fond memories, and it represents loyalty despite separation or challenges, which is the reason why I believe we picked the perfect flower to represent our class. Together, our class has suffered a tremendous loss of classmates, our friends Kendall Tucker and Eric Parisi, both in tragic accidents. Through these trials and tribulations, our class banded together and assisted each other in rebuilding our spirits. We will not forget our dear friends who cannot be here tonight, Kendall and Eric. It is in the name Forget Me Not that we will leave a legacy in the wake of our departure. The class of 2019 truly has a connection that will survive the passage of time, giving us solace for the passing of our friends. Each of us as individuals embody the memories we created at Springstead together. We must not forget where our roots are laid as we depart to go towards the sky in reach of our ambitions to become anything we choose. I wish each of us luck within our future endeavors. Go Eagles. And now, this evening, I am truly honored to introduce my best friend and this year's valedictorian, Ryan Bradley. Ryan and I met freshman year, not knowing we would be building what I'm sure will be a lifelong friendship. Ryan is a type of sister, mentor, and friend everyone needs in their lives. She is the type of person to go out of her way to ensure those around her feel safe, welcomed, and heard. Ryan brings out the best in me and of those around her. For these reasons, I feel blessed to stand here and introduce her tonight. It amazes me how gracefully Ryan juggles the many notable elements in her life, such as being class officer, IB liaison, and a student representative to the school board while remaining 100% committed to these responsibilities. Ryan is truly down to earth, caring, dedicated, and unapologetically intelligent with her impressive 4.68 GPA. Ryan inspires me every day to stay motivated towards my goals and ambitions. Her contagious enthusiasm immediately fills and lights up any room. Ryan will be attending the University of Florida with the intentions of double majoring in accounting and political science with a master's in international business. Ryan hopes to operate her own business and even run for president one day. Without further ado, everyone please welcome our valedictorian, Ryan Bradley.
Good evening, friends, family, and staff. I would first like to thank Leslie for the beautiful introduction, and I would also like to take a moment to thank my parents, my family, my friends, and all of my teachers for always encouraging me to strive for success. I feel so honored to have earned the opportunity to stand before you tonight. The day we have all been working towards has finally arrived, graduation. As we walk across the stage tonight, it is symbolic of our entrance into this next chapter of life, commonly referred to as adulthood. This is an interesting concept, as adulthood is not something you choose to begin, but rather something that is forced. What I mean by forced is prior to this moment, the actions of others have not had profound impacts on our reality, as we were not obligated to take responsibility for the actions of others. Sure, we all have been assigned more work in school or had to run laps during practice due to the unruly actions of a fellow classmate or teammate. And while you and your peers were equally punished for the actions of someone else, you were not seen as responsible for that student's actions. Well, friends, the reality is, in the world we live in today, there are many issues we will need to take responsibility for once we walk across the stage tonight. Education, poverty, human rights, climate change, pollution, violence, and corruption, just to name a few. The actions of yesterday will become the challenges of tomorrow. When I used to think about these challenges, I would say, someone should do something about that. But now I'm ready to say, I'm that somebody who should do something. We are that somebody that need to do something. When I was thinking about what I would write for this speech, I was at a loss because I do not feel as though having the highest GPA means that I'm worthy of giving you advice on your futures. So rather than using my time to flood you with the advice, I would like to talk to you about an experience of mine. This past year, I served as the student representative to the school board of Hernando County. During my time on the board, I cannot express to you the number of times I was asked the following. Is your generation really as bad as it seems? Or is there any hope? These questions baffled me as I worked with students from every single school in Hernando County this year. And all I saw was initiative and heart when it came to facing the challenges in front of them. Not only did I collaborate with my peers at the high school level, but also at the middle and elementary school levels. If our students in Hernando County are any indication of what our future will be like, I can confidently tell you the future is incredibly bright. These students go out of their way to stand up for others, show kindness to one another, and fight for the change they want to see. When I look out at Springstead's class of 2019, I do not see a lazy generation or a generation with no focus. Instead, I see a generation who understands the challenges they will face and a generation who is not afraid to confront them head on. Students, each and every one of us has the power to make a difference in this world. And I trust that together we will. Wherever this next chapter of life takes you, never forget the power you have. Always remember that we are eagles and we soar. Thank you.
Good evening, Eagles and parents. I'm John Stratton, proud superintendent of Hernando County Schools. For the last many years, six or more, I've been involved in high school graduations in some capacity, and I will tell you, it is always a pleasure to come to a red, white, and blue graduation. It is one of the most elegant I see on a continual basis. Congratulations to the staff and congratulations to you students. You look beautiful. Graduates, tonight we officially and formally recognize the successful conclusion of your kindergarten through 12th grade education. Part of the commencement tradition involves offering graduates a little advice to help you navigate adulthood. As educators and parents, that's what we're supposed to do. And as high school graduates, you very respectfully ignore a good deal of part of that. And as educators and parents, we know that too. We know it because we've been where you are tonight, in this strange, wonderful space where there is an end to one part of your education and the beginning of the next. It makes no difference whether you are going on to college, to work, or in the service. All of life is really just continuing education. Because we are all enrolled in the school of life. Let me remind you, class is always in session and she's always taking roll. Don't skip and pay attention because life's greatest lessons help us to triumph over failure, to seek out true friends over those who are false, and to trust our instincts when things appear awry or untrue. We have learned much while you have been with us. And as graduates from our nationally ranked high school, Go Eagles, you should feel just as confident that you will face those lessons and emerge from them with a life full of rich experiences, personal achievements, and great memories. And that is what I wish for each of you. Congratulations to the class of 2019. Thank you for allowing me to have the honor to speak for a few moments tonight. And on behalf of the school board and the entire Hernando County School District staff, we congratulate you and we wish you the best.
And now at this time, I would like Mr. Stratton to receive the official certification of graduation. Mr. John Stratton and the District School Board of Hernando County, on behalf of the faculty, staff, and administration of Springstead High School, it is indeed my pleasure to certify that these members of the 2019 graduating class have completed all requirements of the law and standards for high school graduation as prescribed by the State Board of Education, the District School Board of Hernando County, and Springstead High School, and should thus be awarded a diploma or certificate of completion. And at this time, will the stage party take their places?
Class officer, highest honors, IB diploma candidate, valedictorian, Ryan Bradley. Highest honors, IB diploma candidate, salutatorian, Dustin Falkenberry. Highest honors, IB diploma candidate, Kaylee Ribka. Highest honors, IB diploma candidate, Grace Flogger. Class officer, highest honors, IB diploma candidate, Leslie Bond. Highest honors, AP Academy graduate, Nathaniel Toller. Okay.
Highest honors, IB Diploma candidate, Kyra Riggins. Class officer, highest honors, Grace Andrus. Class officer, PHSC graduate, and highest honors, Melissa Reyes. And now I'd like to take a moment. We have an honorary diploma for Eric Parisi being accepted by Eric's brother, Paul Parisi. Brian Adorney. Joseph Oliva. High honors, Kyron Alvarez. Nicholas Amarelli. Skylar Babcock. Christian Bamman. Sorry. Christian Baguin. Christian Bamman. Tyler Bard. Michael Barrientos. Adam Bass. IB Diploma candidate, Antonio Bellavias. IB Diploma candidate, Stefanos Bellavias. Zion Bell. Carlos Benitez Lopez. Honors, Sydney Sauto. Honors, Khadija Abdul Rahim. High honors, Andrea Abraham. Genevieve Alicia. Honors, Amanda Amando. Lainey Anderson. Highest honors, Haley Andre. High honors, Ariana Aponte. Honors, Angela Asipan. Yeah. Highest honors, Jennifer Ayton. Highest honors, Alyssa Avarello. High honors, Brooke Ayo. Highest honors, Leilani Baez. Claudia Baginski. Mackenzie Bailey. Talia Ballesteri. Veronica Barlock. Honors, Dominique Barry. Kaylee Bishop. Highest honors, Amanda Baldazar. Honors, Madison Brannon. Fiona Brennan. Kimberly Brewer. Danielle Brown. Honors, Dominique Brown. Brianna Burke. Asia Burkhart. Highest honors, Allison Berzamato. IB Diploma candidate, Noah Berlinger. Honors, Felix Bermudez. Matthew Berry. Highest honors, Jason Beanstock. John Bisanti. AP Academy graduate, Adrian Borg. Tristan Bourne. Darian Brown. Michael Brown. Honors, Nico Berberan. Jonas Burns. IB Diploma candidate, Cody Cerencione. Honors, Jonathan Clark. John Cofield. Dominic Calura. Honors, Blaze Connolly. AP Academy graduate, Jonathan Cunningham. Christopher Cusimano. Emmanuel Diaz. Anthony Dorio. Vincenzo Dorio. Tyler Drews. Francisco Dupree. Andrew Eads. Gabriel Elliott. AP Academy graduate, Charles Irwin. Highest honors, John Etzel. Matthew Fansler. Highest honors, Haley Basiglio. Alexis Cameron. Highest honors, Gianna Caparici. Natalie Certain. Honors, Melissa Chamberlain. Honors, Caitlin Champagne. Shatia Charleston. Aaliyah Cherry. Honors, Talia Childress. Susanna Cole. Alyssa Coleman. High honors, Yamilet Cologne Laramont. IB Diploma candidate, Riley Cooper. Honors, Jada Cosin. Phoenix Cruz. AP Academy graduate, Lauren Dean. Isabella Delgado. Congratulations. Honors, Olivia Deloach. Honors, Jessica Detour. Honors, Olivia Devaney. Highest honors, Brooke DeCono. High honors, Madison DeCono. High honors, Jasmine Diocno. Honors, Abigail Donnelly. Highest honors, Trinity Drury. Paige Driscoll. Honors, Michaela Fasulo. Madison Fine. Connor Ferris. Jarrell Fenty. IB Diploma Candidate, Daniel Fernandez. Luke Ferreira. John Figueroa Ramos. Honors, Stephen Fitzgerald. Dylan Flanders. Adrian Fribley. Honors, Max Gabbard. Dominic Garcia. Loides Garcia Ventura. Honors, Damian Giles. Justin Gonzalez. Honors, Carson Gotts. Nicholas Gretsch.
Robert Gross. Carson Grothy. Nathan Crewley. Nicholas Habib. Levi Hall. Harley Hensley. Diego Hernandez. John Hernandez Goitia. Jacob Hilf. Victor Hilly. Honors Jeremiah Holmes. Honors Noah Holmes. Alyssa Fiervante. High honors Nicole Flynn. Alexandra Ferdera. Highest honors, Megan Frank. Highest honors, Heather Fryer. Dana Fulgenzi. Honors Alexis Galmish. Honors Andrew Gangadine. Ariana Gargulo. Honors Mackenzie Garza. High honors Mika Gilpin. Honors Layla Glines. Victoria Grimaldi. Madeline Gutekunst. Felicia Guyette. Honors Kaylee Hackett. Honors Meadow Hadsel. Kayla Hahn. P.
PHSC graduate, Adriana Harris. PHSC graduate, Alyssa Hidalgo. PHSC graduate, Emily Hilly. High honors, Annie Hopping. Honors, Ronnie Howe. Highest honors, Leslie Horaci. Haley Hussey. PHSC graduate, Genevieve Hynoski. IB diploma candidate, Antara Islam. High honors, Melissa Jabajorian. Honors, Stefan Holt. Honors, Torin Houston. Isaiah Howard. Highest honors, Jack Jasiak. Sam Johnson. Honors, Scott Johnson. Jake Jones. Highest honors, Jacob Junker. Hunter Kelly. Honors, Jonathan Kelly. Honors, Mason Corman. Justice Korthloder. High honors, Jerome Langley. Highest honors, Hiavel Lantigua. Logan Lauter. Damon Lempert. Vincent Lynch. Itori Mack. Highest honors, Ryan Maharaj. Matthew Maldonado. Yeah. Noah Mathis. Honors, Nicholas McCaffrey. High honors, Joseph McClure. Bryant McKenzie. Thomas Meese. Honors, Nicholas Mester. High honors, Patrick Moore. IB Diploma Candidate, Brooke Johnson. Darby Johnson. Honors, Tatum Jones. Honors, Laura Joya. Highest honors, Madison Kalen. Highest honors, Hannah Karamitsos. Highest honors, Savannah Klein. High honors, Madison Knight. Rachel Corrick. Highest honors, Emily Kolwitz. High honors, Peyton LaMagno. Honors, Kayleen Langley. Destiny Liali. Honors, Yarinette Lebron. Honors, Devin Letty. Gretchiana Lee. Highest honors, Piper Leastman. Honors, Riley Lemons. Honors, Angelise Levy. Honors, Alexis Locke. Yeah. IB Diploma candidate, Ariella Lombardi. Ashley Lopez. Highest honors, Isangeli Lopez Martinez. Honors, Taylor Lupo. High honors, Alyssa McClenna. Highest honors, Taylor Madsen. Angela Maldonado. Azaria Maldonado. Christopher Morales. Eric Morales. Highest honors, Paul Morrison. Raymond Munoz. Seamus Musicaro Smith. Ian Narvaez Rossi. IB Diploma candidate, Alvin Nguyen. Cody Nigro. High honors, Avery Nomikos. Chris Ortiz. Isaac Osorio. Jason Pagan. IB Diploma candidate, Dylan Palmer. Honors, Athanasios Papadopoulos. IB Diploma candidate, David Parker. IB Diploma candidate, John Parker. Honors, Jonathan Parker. Highest honors, Shay Passarella. Gregory Paul. James Painter. Honors, Rudy Peralta. Derek Pompakti. Nicholas Prendergast. Honors, Christopher Puglisi. Highest honors, Matthew Pulver. Gabriel Quijano. Highest honors, Aiden Quinn. High honors, Evan Quinn. Honors, Jillian Martinez. High honors, Jordan Matusiak. Honors, Mackenzie McIntyre. Honors, Melanie Mesa. Honors, Alexis Malosha. Highest honors, Giannis Montanez. Kaylee Montgomery. Brianna Morris. Miriam Munoz. Shelby Monroe. High honors, Angela Murray. Juliana Napoli. PHSC graduate, Selena Nieto. Highest honors, Vanessa Noah Ramos. Honors, Noemi Nunez. IB Diploma candidate, Rebecca Ortiz. Sheridan Overa. India Pearson. Honors, Carolean Pena Martinez. Honors, Jillian Pepe. High honors, Serena Petrovich. Honors, Taylor Pizik. Honors, Chantal Pinheiro. Honors, Caitlin Primo. Brianna Persino. Desiree Rains. Lisandra Ramirez Valerio. Highest honors, Kyla Rita. IB Diploma Candidate, Will Rainsberger. Highest honors, Brian Radigan. High honors, Patrick Raymond. AP Academy graduate, Amadeus Reif. And thank you. Javier Reynaldo. Christian Reynolds. Jake Rice. Honors, Ryan Richard. PHSC graduate, Bowden Richardson. Moises Rivera. Uziel Rivera. Cody Robinson. Diego Rodriguez. Kenneth Rodriguez. Zachary Rossler. Robert Romero. Brandon Rosado. Dakota Psycho. High honors, Nicholas Savadakis. Joseph Schneider. Highest honors, Dominic Sim. Honors, Nathan Sims. Brendan Savon. Juwan Smith. James Spencer. Austin Stanley. Stefan Statuto. Tony Stinson. High honors, Sarah Redman. Deanna Renzulli. PHSC graduate, Abigail Rich. High honors, Kyla Rivera. Honors, Neralise Rivera. Samari Rivera. High honors, Nicole Rivecchio. Honors, Jacqueline Robin. Sarah Robles Vera. Honors, Kristen Rodier. Symphony Salcedo. Ruth Santiago Diaz. Highest honors, Melissa Sardegon. Honors, Audrey Selby. Honors, Michaela Sells. Highest honors, Megan Speed. Brianna Springs. Honors, Rebecca Stefanu. Sydney Thomas. Breezy Tussing. Highest honors, Gabrielle Van Sickle. Celine Veenstra. Amanda Vega. Highest honors, Alexa Vilka. Melissa Visnaw. Highest honors, Haley Warren. Jasmine Waters. Emma Watson. High honors, Devin Stoddart. Honors, Matthew Sullivan. Zacharias Searles. Honors, Austin Thomas. Honors, Sincere Terrain. Carlos Torres Orsini. Highest honors, George Triantafilou. Honors, Nicholas Tuck. PHSC graduate, Miguel Olgason. High honors, Christian Valdeos. Clayton Vaughn. Derek Villa. Amir Walker Brunson. Benjamin Ward. Honors, Anthony Welshans. Michael Welshans. Honors, Austin West. Joshua Wilcock. Noah Williamson. Honors, Zachary Woodard. Braden Woodcock. High honors, Andy Zhang. Austin Bach. Deshaun Hicks. Ja'Cory Hartman. Harrington Delahose. Kamisha Watson. Maura Webster. High honors, Maureen Webster. Highest honors, Amber White. Honors, Jessica White. Allison Williams. Mariana Williams. PHSC graduate, Jordana Wislow. Highest honors, Lainey Yarbrough. Haley Yilgich. Honors, Catherine Zamora. Kelly Jutra. Indiana Thomas. Aaliyah Torres. Sierra Martinez.
Hey, we're good. We just about ready?
Okay. Before we conclude the ceremony this evening, on a personal note, I would like to take just a moment to say that although I will be moving to a new chapter in my educational career next year, my time as principal at Springstead has thus far been the highlight. I leave here inspired and looking for new challenges ahead. And I trust that Springstead High School will continue to flourish. Springstead will continue to flourish in the excellent hands of the administration team headed by Mrs. Pierce. Seniors and parents, I want to remind you that the diplomas will be available to pick up at that end of the field over there. Immediately following the ceremony. Graduating seniors, please stand and accept our congratulations for your academic achievement. And now, following the lead of your class officers in the traditional manner, class of 2019, you may turn your tassels. And lastly, seniors, please follow your officers one final time doing the spirit chair for Springstead. If you wish to toss your caps at the end of the chair, please remove your tassels at this time. Are you ready?